Hello everyone, in this lecture we are going to talk about the different types of respiration, that is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. As we have already discussed that there is a process in living organisms by which they get the energy, that is respiration. So this energy from the food that we have discussed, glucose, can be obtained in the presence of oxygen also and can be obtained in the absence of oxygen also. So we'll see what are the differences between these two. We'll compare them. So what is this aerobic type of respiration? That process which occur, or that respiration which occur in the presence of oxygen, or we can say the type of respiration in which the breakdown of glucose occur in the presence of oxygen is termed as aerobic respiration. Fine. That type of respiration where the glucose undergo the breaking process without the involvement of oxygen or without the use of oxygen is anaerobic respiration. So this is process in which oxygen is not required. Okay, so this is mainly going to take place in animal cell and plant cell. As we are talking about respiration, we are considering cellular respiration. Okay. So plant cell, animal cell. This is going to take place in bacteria, anaerobic bacteria. Okay. It can take place in yeast. It can take place in muscle cells of human. Also, when there is no or less availability of oxygen to the muscle cells, then they respire anaerobically. Got it? Third, this aerobic respiration is a multi-step process. Okay, and in this, the complete breakdown of glucose occur. Complete breakdown. That will result into production of more energy. Partial or incomplete breakdown. As I told you, the complete breakdown, more energy is released in this process. Aerobic mein zyada energy milegi as compared to that of anaerobic. Less energy is produced. So if I have to write it in the number of ATP molecules, so after the breakdown of one glucose molecule in aerobic respiration, 36 molecules of ATP are obtained. Fine. In the case of anaerobic, only 2 molecules of ATP are obtained. So you can compare that how much less energy is obtained over there. Clear? Next, we'll discuss the other points. So, this particular anaerobic respiration, not requiring oxygen, aerobic requiring oxygen. Next step we'll see where they're going to take place. This aerobic type of respiration take place in, or we can say it occur in mitochondria of the cell. Okay, that's why we used to call mitochondria powerhouse of the cell, because ATP molecules are generated within the mitochondria in this aerobic respiration. In this anaerobic, it occur in cytoplasm of the cell. Okay, hongi dono cell ke andar hi, because we are talking about cellular respiration. Okay, that another where we used to talk about exchange of gases, that is breathing or external respiration. Next, in the case of aerobic respiration, the products which we'll be getting, they are inorganic. Inorganic products are obtained. What are those inorganic products? Carbon dioxide, water. Okay. In this case of anaerobic, organic products are mainly obtained, very less inorganic. So what are those organic products which are obtained as a result of anaerobic respiration are alcohol and lactic acid. Got it? So these are the basic differences in the case of the aerobic and anaerobic respiration. In our next lecture, we will talk about different pathways. Okay, there we'll see where this aerobic respiration takes place, where this anaerobic, and how. Fine. Thank you.